stuff.
Yes, my name is Sarah Lipsey. I live in Mount Rainier and I am on a laptop.
Okay.
And I'm just going to go around the screen. It looks like there's an Alexi. Can you go next? Oh, we're having a little trouble hearing you, Alexi. Are you maybe still on mute?
Yeah, this is our test. This is our good test. Too, yeah, this is our audio.
Well, maybe we can give Alexi just a second. We'll come back. Yep. I know sometimes there's little tricky parts there. Let's see. Is there Kristen?
Hi, I'm Kristen. I currently actually live in DC in Northeast near Gallaudet University. But I'll be moving to West Hyattsville in the new development that's going to be the riverfront development next to the West Hyattsville Metro. So
great.
Wanted to get involved as I'm waiting for house to get built. And I'm on a laptop.
Okay.
And I think Imani, if I'm pronouncing that correctly.
Yes. My name is Imani Kazana, and I live in the Avon Ridge neighborhood, which is just south of Chilham Road, and I am on my laptop.
Okay.
All right. And Joanne?
Yes. Hi. Good morning, everyone. Joanne Buddy, and I am the president of the Avondale North Woodridge Citizens Association, and I'm on my laptop.
Okay. Okay, is that everyone? Alexi, with your audio, where are we landing? We can always type comments into the chat function as well.
Yeah, it looks like I'm reading on the chat over here. I know sometimes, yeah, Teams can be a little tricky with the audio. There's some blips there, but it looks like, Alexi, you found the chat, and we'll make sure to keep an eye on that. Great. And try to voice for you as much as we can.
All right. And that's good. You can hear us. So wonderful. So just to give a quick snapshot of Teams, everyone has turned their video on, so that's great. If you have a question, feel free to type it in the chat box at the top. There's a little icon that looks like a little swoop of a comment box. And there's also an option to raise your hand if you have a question, and we'll be keeping an eye on that as well. We're going to be, as Alexa introduced, we're going to be using two different interactive tools. One's called Slido and one's called Mural.
Video meeting.
And if we have any challenges with those, you know, please feel free to raise your hand. And in some cases, it might just mean refreshing your browser. So tapping on where we type in the web link in your browser, since it seems to be that everyone's on a laptop today, and just hitting the refresh button, and that might solve it. So we'll do our best to help you. And we, when we get into the Mural activity, which is our second activity, we've found that it works best on Chrome, if that's helpful. Abigail's going to be providing a link, but we're going to help you all through this. We're going to get through this. This is a new territory, and we're actually really excited about it. And I think with that, we are going to have about 10 more minutes. For our first breakout activity, we're going to be using Slido, and maybe we'll go ahead, Abigail, if you could share your screen just so everyone can take a peek at what it's going to look like on your end. And we're going to send a link here shortly if we haven't already. But the purpose of this activity, we're going to be creating some word clouds together. And the purpose of this is to think about what you like today in West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel, what you think the neighborhood community could be like in the future. And we're going to see everyone's responses in real time. If you like what someone else had to say, you can type in those same words again. And we're just going to have fun with this. And there's six different questions we're going to ask. The first one is going to be what you see on your screen, which is what's great about West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel today. And Abigail has provided a link. So if everyone can navigate over to the chat box on the side, you'll have an opportunity to click on the link.
And just a heads up, when you do click on that link, first of all, your screen might look a little bit different than mine. You know, mine is that nice blue background. Yours is going to be a white and have an opportunity to type in your answers. And also for the majority of you, once you click on Slido, you might not be able to see us anymore,
that's right.
Particularly if you're in the web browser version and not splitting screens, but that's okay. We're going to give all the instructions verbally. So it's okay if you're just looking at Slido.
So I have a question. So we are actually typing our response in the chat.
You are going to be typing your response. If you were able to click on the link that Abigail provided in the chat,
yes.
It brought you to a website. And there's a question at the top of it. If you can see it, it says, what is great about WHQC right now? And you can literally just type a word in there right now. I see someone has typed in local businesses. And so we're just typing in. It looks like we can type in more than just one word, but that's what we're going to be typing in our responses. And if you like what somebody else had to say, you can type those same words. I'm seeing local businesses, diversity, the supermarkets, close proximity to metro. Diversity is a good one, is what makes many communities in the region. Nice. Trails nearby. Great. I think everybody had a chance to practice typing in? All right. I know this gets very like the fun thing about this is we could keep going. And we're going to have five more questions and they're all going to be to just help us get a sense about what we love today and what are some of the things that we'd like to see in the future. And we're going to do a fun slogan activity at the end. So let's move along to our next question. And on your end, everything should change. That same website that you're in, there should be a new question now. Using one or two words, how would you describe West Hyattsville? This is somewhat similar to the previous one, but to someone who's never been there before. This might be someone, a friend who lives in other parts of the region or a family member who lives far, far away. You know, what are some of those one to two, maybe three words that you would use to describe? Run down, and we're going to actually have an opportunity to elaborate on some of these as we get into some specific focus areas in West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel. Potential, convenient location. Central. Abigail, I see you're managing the chat. Is there anything that is everything going smoothly for everybody up and coming?
Yep, so far we're all in Slido and good to go.
Okay, good. All right, we'll go along to our next question. This is our third question. Everyone should see a new question. I'll read it aloud. Using one or two words, how would you like to describe West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel? Let's think ahead. As Sarah mentioned, this is a longer term plan for the community in 20 years. Clean, walkable, trendy. And if you like what somebody else has to say, feel free to type it in again. Accessible. Diverse. Good. Oh, technical problem. Oh, wanted to add nature animals. I can go ahead and add that actually. Nature animals.
And just a quick note for those of you who might be using the chat, because I noticed, Joyce, it sounds like you're seeing something in the chat that's not showing up in.
Oh, really? Oh, I wonder if this is somebody else's room.
I think you're in the main room. Yep. So.
I added a few things that did not say, which I apologize.
But that is a good note. It reminds us now. So for most of you, if you're using the web browser version of Microsoft Teams, I imagine that's the majority of you. But if any of you are using the app for Microsoft Teams on your computer, you'll be able to access the chat for our room and for that main room. So just make sure that when you're talking in the chat and going back and forth and pulling links, that you're looking in our chat message and not that main room.
That's great. Apologies for adding a couple of random words, but it's okay. We're kind of just, this is a bit of our icebreaker right now. So let's go along to our next question. Voting is closed, and everybody on your screen, I'll read this aloud. It should say, which areas in West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel are the most significant to you? So walking around, driving around, you know, taking transit around the community. You know, for those that are familiar, what places or spaces are special to you? Metro station, Edgar Road. This is where I look forward to the next, because I'd love to hear some of the specifics of why. So I think we'll have an opportunity to get there in our next activity. Hamilton Avenue. I'm not sure yet. All right. Yeah, let's go along to our next question. I think we have two more questions. Oh, no, this is our last question. And this one will give you a moment, because here, you know, Alexa shared a couple of slogans that we know. You know, Austin was one of them, keep Austin weird. There's a lot of tongue-in-cheek slogans out there. So we'll give you just a minute or two, a couple minutes to brainstorm or think about, have fun with this one. Again, this is thinking about the future. What would we want our slogan to be for those, you know, living or visiting West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel?
Yeah, and as Joyce mentioned, this is meant to be super fun, so it doesn't have to even be the most serious one that you would actually want to be for West Hyattsville. It can be something just fun and relevant to your life as well.
Oh,
love okay. That first one.
Oh, my home, multicultural. Yeah, universally designed for all. Yeah, you know, what's neat about that one is that one speaks to some of the transportation and mobility accessibility, but it also speaks to, you know, businesses and parks, and that one's really neat. Artsy. I feel like you all have done this before.
I know. You're amazing. Yeah, here I am adding qualifications. Oh, just make it fun, and you guys are like professional slogan writers over here.
I think with that, we are going to be, I think it doesn't hurt to try to pivot to our next. So we're going to be closing out of Slido and pausing from making our fun word clouds, and we're going to roll up our sleeves and do a little bit more work. And we're going to be using a different platform called Mural. This is the one that we've learned works better on Chrome, and we can help make sure you get to some of the right browsers. I think Edge, Microsoft Edge is another internet browser. But when you click on the link, a lot of us, it brings us to our sort of setting, whatever it's set at. I will say Explorer is one that we've found doesn't quite work.
So if you're still inside, I'll go ahead and first navigate back to yes. Teams so that right. you can access that chat. So if you're just in the web browser, go ahead and just switch tabs at the top or close the tab you are in. And if you're in the app, then head back to the Teams app.
Yep. So we'll be in Teams for a moment as we just give a high level overview of what Mural will hopefully look like on your screen. There's a few things we wanted to point out just to help make sure you have a positive experience using this tool. We've all been practicing for months, and here you have a few minutes to get used to it. So we'll do our best to share all that we've learned about about Mural. The first thing is we're going to be doing three activities. This is a zoom out of the board. What we wanted to point out here was just that you'll have an opportunity to zoom in and out. In the bottom right-hand corner, I think, Abigail, if you could just show us if those have a mouse on your computer. I think most folks are on a computer right now. You can click on that in the bottom right-hand corner, and we'll help you when we get there. And you'll have an opportunity to, if you're using your touchpad on your laptop, or if you have a mouse. And that'll just help make sure that you're zooming in and out properly. We don't have anybody on an iPad, but that would be the pinching in and out as some of us are used to. We're going to be doing two main things using Mural. One is going to be voting by clicking your mouse or tapping on your keypad. Keypad's not the right word, Abigail.
Trackpad, I think that's
your trackpad, what you're looking trackpad. For. Yep. So voting by clicking or adding sticky notes. And those are the two main things, but you're going to see there's a lot of different tools within this, and we can start to have fun as we become more comfortable. Again, if you're having any challenges, Abigail and I had some challenges practicing this, and actually we refreshed our browser and it helped make sure that it could bring the board back up again. The last thing to mention, and Abigail, you know, if I'm missing anything, feel free to help out, but there's going to be a few things as you're in this. One is we as facilitators are allowed to summon you, so that as you can see from this board, there's a lot of different words and pictures and activities to do, and we're going to be summoning you so that on your screen it will move automatically, so don't panic, and it'll start zooming you into these different activities as we move about. In some cases, we're able to take control, which means you won't be able to move about on your screen, and then when we're ready for a particular activity, we'll release you and you'll be able to zoom in and out. Let's go ahead, Abigail. I think it would be good. I was going to introduce our first activity. We're going to have until about 11:25 for our first activity in Mural. But go ahead and we'll add the link. Everyone should now have seen a link posted in the chat function. And similar to before, please click on that link.
And sometimes it does take a minute or two for Mural to load because there's, as you can see from my screen, a lot going on. And when it pops up, it'll prompt you to enter the site. Either you can put in your name and your email, but those are both optional. If you'd like to just enter, just go ahead and click enter site, and it'll give you a fun animal name, visiting panda or something like that.
Yeah, see, we have a sea lion. Let's get our bearings. So we have a sea lion, a crab, a snail, and a lobster.
I think we have about four of our people so far, so let's give it just one more minute.
Yep, and feel free to chime in. If you're having any problems, just feel free to speak freely or add a comment in the chat function if you're having some challenges, and we'll get you set up.
How would I know if I'm signed in?
That's a good question.
Are you able to view the Mural board right now?
Yes.
Then you are signed in. You are good to go.
Okay.
Now, Wita, I wonder how you tell which animal you are.
That's it.
Yeah, that's a good question. I don't know if I can know. I don't think I know whose animal is who, but not particularly relevant for this one.
In the browser, it shows your animal on the lower left-hand side on the screen. Oh. It says AW. If you like, it's your, you know, Abigail, you're signed in as yourself, yep. But that's where it shows what animal you are, if you're curious.
Oh, thanks. See?
Oh, yeah, thanks, Sarah.
So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. Does everybody see in the lower left? And if you have the Mural board open, we're going to be exiting Teams, and you should all be. Not exit, don't close out of Teams, but we're going to be working on your web browser for the remainder.
So let's see, could visiting Panda? Who's visiting Panda, if we know who that is?
It's the funniest roll call. Sorry.
Just to make sure we have everyone. Okay, Alexi is our Panda. Our visiting Sea Lion.
I am not sure who I am.
Okay, yeah.
Where do I see it?
It should be in the lower, Sarah mentioned, so lower left-hand corner, there's a little, there might be a little, like it looks like a little bubble.
A little, a little circle.
I am not seeing mine.
All right, let's see. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. I guess the other way to ask this, is there anyone else who's not viewing their own mural board right now? So of course you can see my screen. So I know we have Alexi, I know we have Kristen, and I know we have Sarah. So we have Sarah, Alexi, Kristen, and then Imani, how's it going from your end? Are you able to view the mural board on your screen? Oh, can you unmute yourself for so that we can.
I see what I see are 1, 2, 3 sections at the top and 3 at the bottom. But this, I don't know what to press from here.
Okay, well, it looks like
all this animal stuff. And I don't know. Oh, at the very bottom here. I don't know.
Okay, well, it looks like I think we have everyone then.
Maybe we're all together.
Yeah, I think we might. Maybe there's more people under here that I just can't see. Well, why don't we go ahead and get started? This might help us out. Let's practice using Mural once or twice. So some of those functionality pieces that Joyce was just talking about. So first, we're going to practice just zooming. So if you have a mouse, you're going to go ahead and zoom just using the roller ball on your screen. So you can go ahead and zoom in by rolling up on your roller ball and zoom out by rolling down with your mouse.
Is everybody seeing it kind of go in and go out?
I can see you doing it, but I can't make it do it myself.
Oh, okay. So you're seeing, so you're seeing what we're doing in Teams.
So let me go ahead. Imani, I'm going to send one more time. Can you open the chat box in Teams? Do you know where that is? If you're in the web browser, it's towards the middle of your screen, about 2/3 of the way down. There's a little, it looks like a little thought bubble with some lines in it.
Which one is it again?
It's the one, it's like, it looks like a little thought bubble. So it's like a circle with a couple little lines in it.
Towards the top, at the top of it,
depending on the app versus the web browser, it'll either be in the top right or bottom center. And actually, Bonnie, maybe let me ask you one other question first. It's totally an option to follow along on my screen. So if you'd rather just follow along on my screen. Okay, perfect. All right, so I'm going to go ahead. I just put a link in the chat. If you could go ahead and click on that link. And if you can maybe let me know what you're seeing once you click that link. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3. All right, we have everyone in Mural.
Everyone's with us.
You're in. This is great. Hooray. Great job, everyone. You got to the hardest hurdle.
This is the hardest part. Yeah. thank you, everybody. So let's go ahead and get started with our first activity. And if everybody has your web browser open, Abigail has just zoomed us into the first one, and we're going to be voting. And so here, since everybody's on a computer, we're going to be, you have up to three votes, and we're going to be clicking on the picture that we prefer. This isn't meant to be like a statistical survey. This is just meant to highlight some of our preferences. And these are meant to be visually oriented. And everyone, again, you'll get three votes and by clicking on the picture. And if you accidentally, because this has happened to all of us as we've been practicing over the past few weeks, if you make a mistake and you have a mouse, you can hit shift and click, or you can right click and it'll subtract if you've double voted. But all of this will become clear as we open up the activity. And I think let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to go ahead and just read aloud the first activity here. There'll be three different visual preference boards that we'll be voting on. So mixed use area activities. And here we have, so which of the services, amenities, and experiences would you like to have in commercial or mixed use area? So these are places to shop or go to the grocery store, maybe go to a farmer's market in West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel area. These could be the areas around the metro station, along Hamilton Street, or south of Chillon. And we're going to go ahead and zoom in. I'm going to read them aloud, and then Abigail's going to open up the voting. So we have window shopping, healthy activities, going to a store, shopping at a locally owned store, going to a farmer's market, living options for all ages and abilities, eating at a local restaurant or a cafe, services or amenities for children, gathering in active public spaces or open spaces. Abigail, if you open it up for voting, you're going to have three opportunities to click on which picture you like best, and you'll have three votes.
So I just opened the voting, so you can go ahead on your screen and click that begin voting button. And just like Joyce said, go ahead and click once on the activity that you like, and then you can do that three times for your three votes.
And there'll be a little circle that pops up in the right-hand corner. Oh, I see everybody's voting. This is, we can see on our end, it looks like, great. It looks like a few folks just have one vote left. All right.
All right.
Abigail, go ahead and let's see where we landed. All right. So everyone on your screen, we can see a summary of the pictures that everybody voted on. And on your end, you'll want to X out it in the top right hand corner. There's a little white X, and you'll X out of the screen by clicking. And here, you know, we'd love to hear, is there any activities that we may have missed? And here, we haven't talked about this yet, but for folks on a computer, which we're all on, you can click the post-it. We're all, Abigail, I think, oh, that's right, we're not in Teams looking at your screen. So everybody on the left-hand side, there's a little picture that looks like a post-it note. Mm-hmm. And if you can click on that, and then double click under did we miss anything, and here we can sort of type in some notes that you'd want to add here. Yeah, I see indoor, that's a really good one, the indoor community gathering spaces for meetings. Uplifting and supporting businesses.
Yep, and I know the text on here can be kind of tiny sometimes, so if it's hard to read, just go ahead and zoom in a little closer, and that'll make it bigger. Or someone figured out you can also make your sticky note bigger, so that's also a good way to make it larger.
Yeah. All right. Let's go along. We have two more visual preference surveys. I wanted to check, is everybody doing all right with this so far?
So far, so good.
Wow. Okay. It's taken us weeks to learn, and everyone's doing such a great job. Thank you. And again, if you have any challenges, you know, feel free to just raise your hand, speak out loud, or send a comment in back in the Teams chat box. All right. So places to gather. These are thinking about some of our outdoor spaces that we have around the neighborhoods of West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel. What activities or types of activities would you most like to do in public spaces? I'm going to read these aloud, and then we'll go ahead and start our voting. So have a picnic at a park, play in a playground, drink coffee outside, run or walk, listen to music, attend a festival, interact with art, watch movies or have an outdoor movie night here, or walk through a meadow. And we'll go ahead and we'll open up our voting again. And everyone will have 3 votes by clicking.
All right, voting is open.
Voting's open. And on your end, you'll see the begin voting pink. And you can just click that and go ahead and get started. Looks like we have a couple votes left, and then we'll move along and close out of this one.
All right, so I'm going to go ahead and end the session. So the results will show up on your screen, and then you can go ahead and close out of those.
All right, so our question is, did we miss anything? Abigail's going to summon or move the screen over for anybody and for everybody, and we have an opportunity to add a sticky note if there's anything we missed, activities that you'd like to do in some of our outdoor spaces. Outreach organization, craft fair.
Do we just click to, how do we do the sticky note?
The sticky note, it should just be on the left-hand side of your screen.
Yeah.
You see there's it looks like a little square picture that is supposed to represent a sticky note. The bottom right-hand corner is folded up. You make sure that that's selected, and then in the actual window that you can see on your screen, you just double click and it should add a yellow sticky note.
Okay.
How do you do the checks if you want to support another posting?
Yeah, yep, that's another one. So on the left-hand side, there's a button that says icons. There's a picture of a star on mine. You can, if you click on that, you'll see a lot of different pictures. You'll see a hand that's looks like thumbs up, thumbs down. You'll see a checkbox. You can click on any of those pictures and just drag it over to the main.
Awesome, thank you. Window.
Yep. Mm-hmm. If you're having trouble with the sticky notes, feel free to just say it out loud, and Abigail and I are happy to add it, by the way. We have a small group and want to make sure that your thoughts are captured here. All right, we'll go along. This is our last visual preference survey. And it should be zooming into something that says mobility options on your end. We're going to have 3 votes. And this says ideally, so, you know, thinking ahead, thinking in the future, how would you like to get around West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel area? Sharing or renting a bike, biking on a network of bike lanes, walking on a network of sidewalks, walking or biking on off-street paths, microtransit. Microtransit is, if you think about a bus route, and which is on a set schedule and set path, microtransit are sometimes smaller buses or shuttles that are more on demand and on a less fluid, on a less strict schedule, and can show up at your house or a meeting place. Electric scooters, driving, taking the bus or metro rail. We'll go ahead and open up our voting. You'll have three votes. Go ahead and hit the begin voting button. Give everyone a chance. I see a couple of votes left. All right, I think that's everyone.
All right, so I'll go ahead and end the session. And again, it'll show you all the results. And then you can go ahead and close out of those so we can move on to what we might have missed.
Sidewalks seems to be a popular bike lanes. Okay, did we miss anything or anything else to add in thinking about mobility? We're gonna have two more activities after this to add more thoughts. So any non-car options are important. I see a but. I see another vote for, safe place to lock bike. Yeah. So need to accommodate safe parking. Metro options for people with disabilities. Great. Is there anything? Yep.
Sorry, that was mine. That was Kristen. So Metro Access is, I think, one of like the mini transit options.
Yep.
So I just wanted, not like the Metro, but like.
No, I'm glad you added that out. Those Metro Access buses. Anyone have anything else to add verbally that we missed? We can help you add a sticky note. All right. So we've tried our two main, we're going to be doing a little bit more voting, but predominantly sticky notes for our next activity. And so we're going to zoom into our second activity in Mural, and there'll be one more after this. And we're going to stay in this activity for about another 15 minutes or so. This is where we have an opportunity to add more specifics about some of the areas of focus within West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel. We now have moved you over to a new activity, so your screen moved automatically. We've identified a few focus areas within West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel. I think at the end, we'd love to hear if we've missed any. And we've mainly focused on areas where we can talk about what is the role that this particular area within West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel should play. What are some things that we'd like to see change or some of the specifics of what those might be? And this is just an opportunity to organize our thoughts around some specific places. I'm gonna just quickly give an overview of the four different areas and then we'll zoom into our first area. So the first one is right around the metro station, West Hyattsville, metro station and the area around there. The second is along Chilham Road and some of the shopping and establishments that we have there as we move southbound into the district. And then the third is the area along Hamilton Street, and this covers both sides of Queens Chapel. So east and west of Queens Chapel. And then the last is, what we've heard is just what are the biggest amenities of the community, which is our parks and open space. And you can see on focus area four, that represents the northwest branch of the Anacostia green spaces, but also thinking about other open spaces that we have in the study area. So I think with that, let's go ahead into our first one. And with this, because we've practiced doing sticky notes, what I think would be good is, we'd love to hear from you, and we're going to spend about 2 to 3 minutes just adding post-it notes in these for these three different questions. So the first is, what are some of the strengths of the area around the metro station? What are some things that you would like to see changed? And then in thinking about the future, again, that 10 to 20 year to 30 year future vision, what is the role that the metro station, the area around the metro station, what should that play within West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel? And if, again, if you're having problems with sticky notes, please send them in the chat box, which is back in Teams, or just say them verbally, and Abigail and I are, we're happy to add them. These are just a few photos that represent or just remind us of the area around the metro station. They're not meant to be associated with any particular strengths or weaknesses. I think with that, let's go ahead and start adding our sticky notes, and I'll give everybody a couple minutes, and then we can chat about them and learn about some of the specifics. Okay. Yeah, I saw the note. Since I'm not a resident. We'll just give folks another minute or so, and then we'll chat about them. And I'd love to hear, if we didn't have a note, just thinking about what's the role of the sort of the future and thinking ahead. Does anyone have any comments that you'd like Abigail or myself to add? If you're having challenges with Mural, happy to do so. Okay. Yeah, so I'm just going to start recapping, and if folks are still typing, that sounds good. So under strengths, we have, you know, transit, and it's a hub for walking and biking, that there are green space connections. That's something really unique about the metro station here, is that it's, you know, right along this major green corridor. Walkability to transit and stores and trails. Right, we've started to brainstorm some things we'd like to change. We have that it doesn't feel safe at night. The businesses attract loitering, which is a challenge. Those are things we'd like to change. Used car businesses, very dangerous road crossing, crossings in general. Yep, those are multiple. And then no stores that are conducive. I'm sorry, I'm reading while you're typing. I need to do that. No stores that are conducive to walking along the corridor. And then, you know, thinking about the role that we'd like to see the metro station area play is that it brings people there. All right. Let's move along to our next focus area. We have about 10 more minutes in here, so if folks have anything else to say or comment or elaborate on, we'd give ourselves that flexibility as well. Okay, so here, you know, these are the neighborhoods along Chilham, south of Chilham, including Avondale Terrace and also Avondale. Again, these pictures are just to remind us of where we're talking about, not necessarily directed at things that we see are strengths as weaknesses. Again, we'll give ourselves just a few minutes to go ahead and start adding sticky notes, and then we'll chat through it. A couple minutes. All right. Let's chat through what we have here. Pardon me, I'm just pulling my screen up. Got it turned around. All right, so some of the strengths, vital businesses is a strength, and nearby Dunkin' Donuts. Some of the things to change, there's so much potential, but it's unattractive. There's sort of stores that we never go to. There's stores along Queen's Chapel, but those that we don't visit. Would love to see different types or higher quality shopping. This one's really important, which we talked about around the metro station, is that you take your life into your own hands just across the street. And I see some voting on the last two. So the role that this area should change is just be more welcoming area, since it's right on the Maryland-DC border. Yep. And then, you know, ways to link it to the Hamilton Street corridor with more decent sidewalks. And I see a new addition, garbage and, so there's just garbage and plastic and illegal signage everywhere. So just the overall public realm cluttered and better options for traffic. All right, let's move along to our third focus area. Okay. How's everybody doing? okay, so here we have the Hamilton Street corridor. And again, this is on both sides of Queen's Chapel. So east and west of Queen's Chapel, where we have our more Main Street area. We also have Aldi's as just a few markers for folks. And we'll go ahead and spend a few minutes filling it out here. I see some similarities. Don't want to rush out there, so feel free if you have other comments, or again, just feel free to chime in if there's something you want to elaborate on or say verbally, and we're happy to add your note here.
Well, and Joyce, from my end, I just have to comment on what a great job everyone's been doing with Mural. I know new technology can be kind of intimidating sometimes, yeah. So we appreciate how much you've all just jumped right in and are doing a really great job with it.
I will say, you know, there's a report back that we're going to do at the end. And I was just, the reason why I was a little sidetracked is I was trying to find some of the slogans that we wrote, and I didn't take a screenshot because that would be great to report back on when we all come back together at the end. I was trying to figure out how to go back in and find that, but.
I can, I'll put a quick screenshot in the chat for you, Joyce.
Oh, you had a screenshot of the slogans?
I'm pulling it up right now.
Oh, okay. Oh, cool. All right. That's great. Yeah.
Right, I'll put it in our group chat so that everyone can see it, since we did have some really awesome ideas there.
Yeah. Okay, so Hamilton, this is a neat comment. It's just perfectly located. It has the perfect DNA. And it genuinely neat, small, locally owned restaurants. So those are some of the strengths. Some of the things that we talked about wanting to change, loitering, drunks problem, perennial problem, second-rate stores and restaurants, parking important to businesses, but people are exiting and parking drive unsafely. Okay, so are these all the like the in and outs of the parking spaces and the parking lot behind Hamilton Street? A lot of in and out movements. And then, you know, the role that Hamilton Street should play in West Hyattsville-Queens Chapel. It should be a place to stroll and eat and shop safely without being run over. That's related to the last one. A place to walk about with your family. And this should really be the center of Hyattsville and should block off car traffic between Ager and Queens Chapel and make it pedestrian only. Oh, that actually, I haven't heard that one yet. this should be the center of Hyattsville Main Street. Okay, so let's zoom in to our, Abigail's gonna bring us over to focus area four. We're gonna shift gears a little bit. We've been talking about areas where there might be more development or commercial uses, and we're gonna talk about our parks and open space, which is one of the things that we love most about West Hyattsville Queens Chapel. Just love to hear some of the strengths, what we'd like to change, and again, the role that our linear parks and also smaller parks should play in the community. Give everybody a few moments and then we'll chat through. Oh, I'm going to go ahead and start reading these off. We've got some really good ones. So I just looked up after taking some notes. So some strengths, like having coffee by the Northwest Branch, very beautiful trails in our community. Could you imagine if the stream was swimmable? Wow. Yeah. Kind of gives you chills. Such a great connections. Can go all the way to Greenbelt, Silver Spring, Anacostia, easily on trails. Some of the things we'd like to change, more access to the Chilham roadside. Yep, more seating. Some parts of the trails don't feel safe, and there's a need for better lighting. Mm-hmm. So the role that it should play is for that of recreation and exercise, pedestrian commuters from metro to home, and then a way to bring people to our community. All right. I guess with that, let's zoom out of our focus areas. Is there any kind of feedback or comments anyone wants to make before we head over to our last activity? All right, I will go ahead and introduce our last activity. And then if we get through it, I would love to hear any notes from you all of when we do our report back of what you might want to emphasize. All right, so this is our last activity. We're going to be zooming in and out of quite a few of these. But so here we're thinking about the future. These statements, these are vision statements. They're draft vision statements. We took our best guess at a couple of different vision statements for the future. Thinking back to that first exercise we did where we have our slogan and just what we've moved through together as a group today. We're going to read off these four statements, and you'll have an opportunity to let us know if you can see yourself in the vision statement or if you do not see yourself in the vision statement, and anything that you might want to change about that. So we'll be voting and adding sticky notes here. And then at the end, what we'd love to hear is, you know, it's hard to vote on, I think, one, but we'd love to hear if one in particular, they all have a slightly different perspective on the future. And we'd love to hear if one you related to that the most. And then I'll introduce the final activity after this. So with that, Abigail's going to just zoom us into the first vision statement. I'm going to go ahead and read it aloud. And we're going to set up, we've been doing voting for this one. So we'll see how that, I think we'll do that again. But first, if you will, I'll read this aloud so we're all on the same page. And I'd love to hear if you see yourself or do not see yourself. So first, West Hyattsville-Queens Chapel. It's unique, it's diverse, and people's differences are treasured. They're not just tolerated. Visitors return to West Hyattsville-Queens Chapel to experience the community, the culture, services, and amenities. Community events and festivals allow locals, regional residents, but also visitors to share music, food, and ideas. And so here we're going to give everybody a chance to pick one vote. And so I just wanted to point out before we go in is you'll want to click on I see myself and my community represented. You'll want to click on those words, or if you do not, where it says B, you'll want to click on the words I do not see myself or community represented. We'll go ahead and begin our vote. Okay, I think that's almost everybody. Just one more vote I see left. Can't remember who Visiting Owl is. That's okay. Oh, we got everybody. Okay, good. All right. We'll go ahead and close out and just kind of get a snapshot. Looks like everybody sees themselves in this vision. And if you will, X out of the screen, you have a black screen, and you can just hit in the right top right hand corner to X out. Is there anything, by adding a post-it note or just saying aloud, we have a smaller group, is there anything that you would change about this first vision statement that we just talked about, or anything else you would add? Feel free to add a sticky note here again, or just say it aloud. And Abigail's hovering her cursor over it. Says, what would you add or change about this vision statement, if anything? Yep, exaggeration. Maybe just something about all of these events being accessible to all. So another accessibility. Yep, is there anything else that anyone would change? All right. I guess with that, we'll move along to the second one. Again, we're going to vote on whether or not you see yourself and community represented, or whether you do not see yourself. But first, I will read this one aloud. West Hyattsville-Queens Chapel supports local businesses and has a strong working relationship with the University of Maryland and other key sectors that help people find ample opportunity in West Hyattsville-Queens Chapel and the county more broadly. This is a place where small businesses thrive and entrepreneurs choose to start and grow their businesses here. And we'll go ahead and open up a voting session similar to before. You'll want to click on the words I see myself and community represented, or you'll want to click on the words I do not see myself or community represented. With that, you can go ahead and begin voting. Looks like that's almost everybody. All right, we have all our votes in. All right, so four said you see yourself and one not so much. love to just hear by adding a post-it. Again, you can click in the top right-hand corner if you haven't already. Love to hear if there's anything you might want to change about this. More of a nexus between University of Maryland. Again, don't take advantage of the University of Maryland enough. Right. Anything else to add? With that, we'll move along to the third out of fourth vision statement, and at the end, we're going to vote on our favorite if we could pick. All right, so vision statement number three, again, this is looking into the future, although it's written in the current tense. West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel, it has vibrant neighborhoods. Young singles, families, children, and seniors live in diverse housing types throughout the area. People know their neighbors and they work together to care for each other. Children walk and bicycle to their neighbors and they walk and bicycle to their neighborhood schools. Every resident can find shopping, recreation, and open space with an easy walk of their homes. So option A, if you see yourself, option B, if you do not, and again, we'll click right on the words themselves. I see myself in community represented, or I do not see myself for community represented. Looks like that's almost everybody. Just one vote left, I think. All right. Close on out of that. All right. So this one, people related to it. Is there anything you might tweak or change about this particular vision statement? So, yep, council members more active in promoting these traits. Yeah, so a lot of it is about, I mean, there's what we do as community members, but there's more broadly what our elected officials and the role that they play on this. This goes to agencies as well, so that's a good one. All right, let's move along to the last one. Go ahead and read this one aloud. All right, West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel residents treasure natural environments. The Northwest branch of the Anacostia River, it's healthy, it's vibrant. We should put in parentheses and you could go swimming there. Solar panels gather energy on rooftops, community gardens dot the parks, and native species grace yards, parks, and open spaces. It's easy to walk and bike in West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel, as it is to drive. West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel is connected to DC and the rest of the county through strong transit systems. Growth is phased, it makes efficient use of land, and it ensures that the community is vibrant. So we'll open up voting again, and you'll click on the words, I see myself and my community represented, or you can click on the words, I do not see myself or community represented, thinking about the future. All right, I think that's it, everybody. All right. right. So, well, this is going to be hard. So we're going to zoom out to all four. I'll give a quick recap.
At first, I'm going to quick zoom people in case they want to add or change anything.
Yes. Yep. You're right, Abigail. Yep. Does anyone have anything that they change about this particular vision? This is too broad. Yep, see walk and bike. Just going to give another minute. I see someone's finishing the thought. I'm going to read just a couple of these. So lots of community groups, green teams working on the vision, involve them. Can I ask a question? I guess you add that. Are there existing either green teams in the community today?
The city of Mount Rainier has a green team. I'm the chair of it. And, you know, I know only a little bit of the space is in the city of Mount Rainier, but I believe Hyattsville also has a green team. And both Brentwood and North Brentwood do as well. So they do exist. And there's the Greater Sustainable Maryland group as well.
Okay, great. No, that's good. And, you know, the comment is just this is a really broad and agree with about sort of a half of it. I see walk and bike, but that may not be how everybody gets around. So I think that's really interesting if we need to be thinking bigger when we think about mobility. And then, yeah, Northwest Branch is not healthy. I guess with that comment, we're thinking about today, not healthy. All right, let's zoom out. I got ahead of myself. So now we're gonna, I think, Abigail, you're right. So we should, I wanna make sure we give ourselves enough time. Abigail, this one ends at 12:15. Is there anything I guess it's good to make sure, like, have we missed any vision elements of these four? Okay. All right, Abigail's going to summon us, and we're going to pick if there's one of these that we relate to the most. You'll have an opportunity to click on the actual words. So the first one, you could all tell they had a slightly different perspective. The one skewed towards community. The second one was about businesses. The third, more on mobility. And the fourth, again, on the environment. So you'll have an opportunity to click on the actual boxes where the vision statements are to pick which one you relate to the most. And if it's hard, I see a question, which is good. What do you want us to do? my apologies. So I know I can see that no one's voted. So one person, Kristen. So here we've opened up voting for this one. And so you can click on number one, number two, number three, or number four in these four different vision statements on your screen. If it's hard to pick, we've talked about each of them individually. We are perfectly comfortable not forcing
you. And just to add, you're picking the one that you relate the most to, or that's your favorite out of these. So it's just a personal preference of the one that you like the best.
Yeah, and you should be able to click on the words themselves of the vision statement. All right. Visiting Sea Lion, I think you're our last, and it's okay if you choose not to, but All right, let's move along because we have one activity to do in our last about 10 minutes here. We'll go ahead and close out. So definitely a good mix. All right, so for our last activity, if you X out of the screen in the top right-hand corner, we're gonna zoom in. So we've covered a lot today. And so I wanted to thank everybody for being with us on a Saturday. Again, we're gonna be together for about another 10 minutes. And our last activity is related to the vision, but it's breaking it out into smaller bite-sized pieces. As we think about five or so six different themes. And the first of those is neighborhoods, housing, community facilities. So these could be public schools, our rec facilities, and our actual neighborhoods themselves, and the types of places that we use for our living or visiting different public facilities. One thing that we've heard quite a lot about is affordability and affordable housing, and how that's something that we might want to maintain or prioritize over time. And so we've taken a cut at just adding one post-it here. And so we'd love to hear, in thinking about our communities and different public facilities, feel free to go ahead and start adding some post-its for what we should prioritize within these different buckets. And I think one thing important to mention is that what we're getting at here is vision statements are really broad, and these are meant to sort of support and add more specificity to some of the recommendations that we might look at moving forward in the sector planning process. So no more chain link fences. I think maybe this is probably getting to like making sure that our public amenities feel open to the public and aren't barricaded off. Yep, someone's at it. Need indoor community buildings for activities, particularly in unincorporated areas. I see a lot of votes for accessible community facilities. Anything else for, we've kind of grouped together a few different things here. Anything else to add? We can move along to the next one. All right, so it should have zoomed automatically on yours and thinking about, economic development, or we've talked quite a bit about businesses in our commercial areas in West Hyattsville, Queens Chapel. We just started to add a post-it supporting local businesses, boosting local businesses. That's a good one. Anything else to kind of add on the business side and thinking about sustainability of businesses over time? If there's anything that you want to add just verbally, feel free to chime in, and we're happy to help type it in for you. Boost local businesses like Hyattsville Trail Charlie Trail. All right, looks like we have about 5 minutes left, and we have three more categories. The first one is mobility. And we talked a lot about getting around safely and making sure it's the community is accessible. So mobility, I think the point that this shouldn't be just defined as ways to bike and walk around, equitable access for all ages and ability. Anything else to add when we think about prioritizing decent sidewalks? So this is good to talk about. I think I'm glad we're mentioning preserving parking, because that's something that's come to mind, and we've talked quite a bit about this as we've done our existing conditions, is there is a lot of parking in the community, and kind of preserving it for making sure our businesses are accessible. That's a good point. not using brick for walkways. Is that because of the trip hazard or maintenance? Wheelchair users. Yep. Okay. Better sidewalks along Queen's Chapel from Chilham Road all the way to Hamilton. All right, anything else for transportation? We'll move along to second to last, which is equity and inclusion. Our first vision statement, I saw the point, this is very aspirational, but how do we maintain in our, one of our slogans that we developed, I saw someone had a comment about multicultural, and we know diversity is important. Any specific priorities or recommendations for us to look at when thinking about equity and inclusion? Yep. Getting interpreters for meetings, captioning, videos. Image descriptions for pictures. Wayfinding, that's a good ad for transportation. So, I think as we move forward in this process, we're, definitely more at a midpoint. I think we'd love to hear just more thoughts on how to better connect with the broader community. Okay, so let's move along to the last, and whatever little time we have, I would love to hear just if anyone has any other feedback in general on today's breakout group and how we can continue to engage and do better. So, okay, environment and sustainability. We just added one post-it to get brainstorming, just energy efficient buildings, but this could play out in our sidewalk spaces. Adding more green space, talked about the Northwest Branch, our parks, modern stormwater management. But it's expensive, I know. Yep, ample trash cans. One of our activities talked about keeping the area clean, business-focused incentives, trees. Business-focused incentives for green activities.
Joyce, I don't know if you saw the one, but we have less than a minute.
All right. Well, we wanted to thank you for spending the time with us in the breakout room. Is there anything else to add for those who spent your time with us today? Thank you, everybody. We really appreciate it. And we're going to all be... we're all going to be zoomed back to the main room for the wrap up. And we really, again, appreciate all your thoughts and time and participation. Thank you.
Thank you.